Each drawing should contain a description which we will put in the table. To do this, we need to print out the table accordingly. But because there will be some help for us, let's create a layer. Such an auxiliary window, click now. New and let's give it a very strange color. Let it be known that this is a layer which normally does not appear in the drawing, only something we draw. So supportive. So we're going to change to this layer now. The current layer is done. And now we will draw a line that will mark us. Amount of writing space. We will divide this line. And suppose it's 3 blocks, whereas this division is marked only by points while the object itself is not physically divided. We'll draw lines, let's assume 1/3 here, perpendicular. Now to have the whole writing field, so we will extend this line by lengthening the grip. Now we have a middle place to write. That is how we will write on the principle that the center is even. So it will always set us up in this way. The same can be used in the second box. We have the last command executed under the right mouse button. So we repeat the line and we can draw. Now that we have such designated midpoints, then we can write the text. And we will do this alignment as a measure. That is the middle point of the text. Now it is necessary to accept it with center so that it does not twist the whole text. And model 1 and enter a second time to finish writing the text. Scale. Then we will repeat the text again. Middle 1. We accept angle 0, 1, 1. And enter twice to finish writing the text. Such a construction could be repeated further, but maybe first clean up. And so the model and we wrote this auxiliary layer, so we move to the table layer. In general, let's switch to the table layer. And now this text will be set the same way as in the following fields. And you could draw auxiliary and so on, but because we already have this text based on the entire frame, then we can copy it on the principle that we will take the text and as a base point copy we will take the end of this frame. And now as we are going to copy to the next fields, we have already set this idea. It is always inside. We skipped the date because we will write in it differently because the date has a variable length. Therefore, here we will do something like that. From this base point to perpendicularity we will determine to have the same height. We will shorten this line to the frame size so that the text does not fall on the frame, We will do the trick. We stretch it one way and one and half. Why? Because the text is skewed so that it does not overlap the frame on the right, it is a bit more that we have pushed away. Now correcting the text will be that we click the text and correct the material street 45. Weight of 10 newtons. Figure 1. And we'll insert the date a little differently. We will adjust the date so that it fits. In this prepared line. So we'll force AutoCAD to scale our text itself. Actually just the width of this text. And let's assume it's 20th year. As you can see, AutoCAD automatically rescales. We can throw this line away. And we have filled up. We will do the same with a line next to the name. Because the name will also be variable length, because not always the same man will do the truth here. We will write the text. We can fit him from place to place. And it will be and this line is no longer needed in the signature. We will do it on the principle that we will sign now. The signature will be based on the principle that we will sketch it. We'll start writing the name of the SCA command. And now we have the signature will be large. And it is done on the basis of the mouse click and start writing. But as you can see here, we are disturbed by the ortho function because it does not smooth us. We turn off the ortho function. And we will start again. And we begin. And we finish. We have created such a block. Of course he is big, and because we have drawn as big because we want to eliminate the difference between writing with your fingers and writing with your hand. How to deal with it now? Well, from such a sketch of my own, we're making a block. So we say to create. The base point block is determined on the screen. And choose on screen and OK. we will choose the base point somewhere on the left and say that these are all centered elements. And it's stuck together into one block. Now, we will insert this block, but here the block would not fit. Therefore, let's take the scale. And let's set this scale for now. And see if it suits us. If this scale suits us. If not, then we are making the next attempt to make it fit enough to fit in the frame. Now we will break this block and create again. Enter the same name. And we agree to redefine this block. And the base point will be the end and all objects. As you can see, we have changed the block. Of course, this block has also changed because we have modified this block. We haven't put it in the right place. Now we put in the block and because it doesn't show us the intersection. To control right and choose intersection. And we have already remembered the block of the right size and in the right place. Now just for order. We will turn off this auxiliary layer, and in this way we have prepared a table that can be used. If we save it as a template, then of course it will consist in using it. As we have to change something, then we enter the given text and change. While all setting and leveling functions will be remembered here. Thank you for your attention.